Good afternoon, all. I believe I'm the first industry speaker for the day. And typically, you know, engineering guys, we have presented a lot of engineering forums, but this is one of the first times where we are presenting to the teachers, right? So I want to be sure, you know, presenting to them is a tough job. So let me start off by just introducing myself. I carry around 2 decades of engineering, and throughout I've been only involved in engineering. So when I see really passionate teachers over here, I can really feel the difference. And I came with a very well prepared slide deck. But after I saw really, you know, folks speaking here, they're really speaking from the heart. Do I need to really go through the slides, or really I speak from my heart? And I thought, let me really speak from my heart rather than really start going through the slides itself, right? So quickly, so my wife as well is a teacher now, but she was an pretty much very highly paid engineering graduate working in one of the IT firms in Bangalore. And then one fine night around 1 a.m. or something, right? And that's typical for all our IT guys, right? We have all the meetings running still, you know, 1 a.m., 2 a.m. and all that, working 24/7. And then one fine night she said, you know, you're staring at an owl. You know, all night I see you're staring like an owl, and you know, this is what is happening every day. Well, I would have expected something interesting or different, but at least owl is better than anything else. So I thought it's okay. And she said, you know, I'm going to put the papers right now, and from tomorrow I'm going to really look at something interesting. I was a bit surprised. Wow. From tomorrow, and 1 a.m. is too late to make that decision. And she was very clear. And morning she made, and she was clean clear with her thoughts, and she went on to teach the poor children, the orphan children, the socially abused children. And on the outlook, I thought it's a very easy job, right? You go pull in few kids, start teaching or preaching or whatever it be, right? But then I realized that it was getting really so difficult, and so many kids didn't turn up the next day, so many challenges. And there were children whose parents were alcoholic, they didn't want the kids to go to school, and so many other things. Then they, you know, these people go to really pick the kids, you know, they're all stopped. Right? And that's where when Arun was speaking, I was wondering, how is he even able to run it? And undoubtedly, he has been going through a lot of challenges. And that's when I started seeing there is a lot of things that's happening here. And having said that, but I could never come out of the industry when I am still, I continue to be a hardcore engineering guy. And so I thought, at least let me try to see and find a solution to what this industry transformation is happening in the education sector. And can I really do something out of my engineering to really bridge the gap? And that's where I started really getting into to try to see what it is. And the problem statement that really what we are really trying to address, and I think Neeta ma'am really said, create, communicate, and collaborate. And almost every single speaker from morning who spoke about have been talking about one single problem. There are really passionate teachers within this room. But do they have the ability to go and reach to somewhere in the remote part of any of the country? Not really. They can do it in Delhi, they can do it in Bangalore, they can do it in West Bengal, they can do it in Delhi, some other parts of the country, main metros. But in case you want to take this knowledge that you have to the remotest part of our country, do we have a technology at ease? I believe not. And that's precisely the problem we tried to address. And we wanted to keep it really simple. We wanted to keep it really lightweight, and we wanted to give that feel of experience, which means as much as if I'm talking in person with you, this is the same kind of experience can I get through a technology, right? That was the objective that we wanted to solve. And we wanted to really get everything in a real small box that you can just put into your bag. The most smallest bag I would assume here, whatever it be, I can see a red bag there. Probably in that you should be in a position to put it in and take it. Can I create it? So today the solutions that we have are pretty complex. People market a lot. Of course, we talk about high-end projectors, we talk about high-end computing technologies and all that. I'm not going to talk anything high. My objective was very clear. Can I make something very simple that can be taken to any part of the classroom, right? Have it portable, plug it in anywhere, you want to move it around, go ahead. And can you get that experience, right? The so-called complete experience can be bringing. That was the objective with which we started. And the second thing is the affordability itself. And I heard many of them really talk about schools in remote villages, schools in different parts of the country. But believe me, last couple of years we have been really traveling the breadth and length of all over India, really trying to understand, are we doing the right solution? And I think, slightly I might be disagreeing here is that the problem exists even in the metros. That's what I really see. Because I have been a student of IIM Bangalore, and when I sat in IIM as well, the same challenges were there. You get into, one of the best professors I know in economics, we love to really sit in his class. But my counterparts in Hyderabad, they were not getting really what the professor here was teaching. Every time there was disruptions, technology disruptions. So what is the problem? Right, we are really talking about bandwidth today. How minimalistically, in the lightest possible bandwidth, can you really offer the best solution? Probably, still you are talking about 512 kbps. That's fine still, right? We are not in a phase where everywhere we have 2 gigabits or whatever it be and so on and so forth. So even the lightest possible, can we have a solution that is seamless, right? What is the real problem today? Today, you have really bulky solutions and very expensive solutions. And that's not really affordable. And we wanted to come up with a business model which can really fit into every single person in this room. And this is what we were really trying to get to. So what is the solution then, right? We wanted to really bring in an integrated solution. So to be frank, this is a solution that we conceived, conceptualized, and brought in the last couple of years, right? So not rocket science. We really went into, spoke with children, spoke with the educational fraternity, spoke with different learned people who really said what their problem is. They wanted to really go to the level of really seeing the student so close to perfection. When a student really gets up to ask a question, you don't expect the technology to come and really eye on, click on this and that and other things. So that's where really we brought in the experience itself. If a student raises the question, the instant automated the camera zooms into that person so that the teacher who is really speaking from probably in one of the metro is in a position to really understand the emotions and expressions of that student. They should be in a position to connect. They should be in a position to collaborate. And when two classrooms are really talking, there's a classroom in Delhi and there's a classroom in Bangalore, both the classroom students need to be able to interact and collaborate among each other, which means they should be in a position to share content. It can be international school, it can be really remotest of the village. A student from an international school wants to really share something to the remotest student of the village, why not? It's about really sharing knowledge. And how can we really share knowledge? Why only we are only focused around the real core subjects, right? Why are we not talking about music? And our friend from, I think, Ladakh, they really spoke about, all this, courses around, self-defense and so on. Why don't we do that from here sitting remotely? There are a good amount of people within, Delhi who can really do that, right? So we can really do this through this technology only when we can really bring it really close to you, right? So that is what we really brought in. So we brought in streaming as well, which means if there is a class that's happening very specific to, physics, then the students who are interested in that, they can really go and sign up to it, and free of cost, right? They're going to be really making use of it, they're sharing knowledges, they're really talking about it. And in all this, one thing that I've seen is fundamentals. A person who understands fundamental, at any point of time in their career, if you really talk about the Pythagoras theorem or any of the complex things, I'm not the best guy. But I can really look back and say that the math teacher who taught me, really taught me fundamentals that today I can correlate and say that it is applied in the most complex, San Francisco Bay Bridge. And how simple they could really adapt it to really fit into it. And this is what precisely you folks are good at. And all that I can offer is a solution through which you can really meet the end students. Right, so that's where we really came into picture. So we also integrated with the learning management system. So we already have a good amount of curriculum in place, a lot of knowledge base in place, which can be shared with, across, and it's free. And as the teachers also start adding in new content, we are really going in a way where the content can keep enhancing on an ongoing basis. Right? It can absolutely work on the least bandwidth. It can be connected on Bluetooth. It can have cellular access. Every single thing is absolutely there in place. It works on a very low cost model. In the sense, our objective is that this hardware is completely available free to the schools. They can take it, they can deploy it. And the model that we are really looking at is really going with a very minimalistic, less than $2 per person, $2 or $3. That's the kind of thing that we are talking about. And in today's world, what we believe is that's for the knowledge base and the economy we are trying to really shift. That's pretty minimal. And can we really keep on an ongoing basis, increase the content itself? And last but not least, also what we are really exposing is all the APIs are going to be exposed northbound. And it's a pretty technical term. But the advantage there is that you want to integrate any of your products, knowledge bases, anything with this hardware, you'll be in a position to do it seamlessly. And anytime and every time, you can keep adding. I know Ravi is already raising the hand. We're running out of time. So I'll try to quickly flip through. So all these technologies are perfectly integrated. We have a booth across there, so feel free to come in. We'll be more than happy to walk you through a lot more things. So currently our focus is around the education sector, but we are also integrating a lot more other knowledge bases, which becomes an integral part of it, and this gets really go to the level of every home segment. And as a pretty cool technologies guy, where also I want to get to is, why even really go set up a call and really do all these things? Can I go to the level where you're going to be talking to that device itself? So we are going to be integrating down the line with speech related things and so on and so forth. So that is why we would want to get to. So as I said, we would want to make it as lightweight as possible, as seamless as possible. We are a pretty much startup, but at the same time, our product is already in pilot in Bihar and other states of the country. Very much successfully running. So you folks can really come, look into it, and we'll be more than happy to spend some time with you folks. With that, this is my last slide, assured. So we started the journey, as I said, 2 years back, we started looking into where, how to move forward. But then we clearly shifted gears, and as education secretary also spoke about, we shifted gears from pilot to really having the product in place. Today we have the product in place. And at the same time, we also wanted to be sure that we are very closely connected with this industry. This industry is clearly going through a digital transformation. So if we don't really shift gears quick, we are going to be left behind. So we also want to be sure that we are connecting globally all these product lines and we have seamless progressive approach in place. And lastly, as Madam said, a platform through which you can create, communicate and collaborate. With that, thanks much for the opportunity provided here and hope you stay. Thank you.